What's up, guys? And if this is your first time on the channel, welcome to Last Humans Garage. What I want to talk to you about is actually a tire issue that I'm having. Nothing to do with this thing, but so these tires are rubbing only on bigger bumps, I should say, but they rub pretty good. Now I don't think it's the edge rubbing. I mean, I don't know anything about this. I don't think it's the edge gonna cut it or anything. I think it's hitting on top or something. And first, like, I'm not too worried about it if, like, nobody else is, you know, like if it's just, hey, it's gonna like rub somewhere. But I've heard it, like, and there's so much clearance here, right? It isn't going to be here. It doesn't dip an inch and a half. But, I mean, that's even higher. Like, I'm wondering, you guys would know the most common places for rubbing. That's just weird. And it's just felt, like I said, I really don't care. We got a lot of room. See in the backs, we got a lot of room there. But, I mean, on big bumps and dips, then when the rear drops, it scrapes. And maybe it's probably too early to see any markings yet, you know, because it hasn't really started scraping, but man, it's scraping. Let me see. And I believe I've seen it on the fronts and the rears. I mean, I could fold down that little fender piece right there. I don't think I need to. No, that's miles away. I wouldn't need to touch it. But see, I don't really see any scraping on the edge, which I would be worried about. But like, it's you know, folded up anyway, but that has a lip inward. There's no way that's gonna go that far. So I'm just confused, and this was driving in a straight line, of course. I'm just confused, like, where could it be scraping? So anyway, all you guys that have 10 years more wheel experience than me can start me out with some ideas on that. You guys almost know the most common spot, and then that's going to end up being my spot because it's so close. So although I had kind of tossed out my rear shock ID and said I don't need that, this issue brought me back to that. I definitely think some Bilstein monotubes are going to be a little stiffer than these and maybe stop it from dipping more. I know springs are what handle the compression, not the shocks. They just stop the compression, they stop the bounce. But I'm thinking if I got a little bit stiffer shocks, which I plan to do anyway, honestly, like, I mean, imagine completing the car to that level now with everything else. We said it's done. What if I get Bilstein top line shocks in all four corners? I don't want coilovers, don't even mention it. I'm already lower than I like to be. So that's it. I might get new I mean, it's probably beyond for the year. It'll be on the project list. Rears are easy. I dread the fronts, but if it would make my car even better, I'd probably suffer through it. It's a lot better than trying to put all my lift springs on there like I used to, where you got to fit a bigger spring in there. It's impossible to get it in. But if I'm just doing stock for stock, putting on some Bilsteins, I could probably get by it without, you know, pulling out an axle or anything like that. So that's my topic on that. What should I do on that? One sec, I don't waste your time. Let's see what else, if I got anything else for you today. I remember what I was thinking now, guys. The other option to stop the scraping would be to put a little itty bitty half inch lift on the strut tops of all four corners. Little half inch, like I also plan to do, actually. From time to time I plan it. I don't really get that serious about it, but that's another option. I'd love it higher, but I wouldn't love is having to adjust that alignment and steering wheel and headaches because it's so perfect right now. But I would definitely like love it a half inch more, and it would probably stop all this tire scraping. But oh, would that just take away the wheel gap that I just gained? gotta listen for the bubbles. I don't wanna overflow. Whew. So yeah, I mean, I'm not seriously considering the spacers, but I mean, why not? If they solve my issue, you know, why wouldn't I?
I know, cause they're stupid.
Yeah, whatever. So yeah, just give me some tips, or can you please offer some advice on the most common tire rubbing issues, what you think may be happening. Obviously, this is all caused by myself. I'm the one that wanted 45 profile, and I don't even regret it. It looks so good. I mean, shoot, I better hide this new stereo system to replace this old junk, putting in a proper system, the same computer systems that I've used. I bought 5 or 6 of those Kelps systems now. They're always the most reliable things in the world, and the best sounding sound quality autofill ones. So yeah, I'm putting that in here. I need to find some kind of input for it to plug in. It's just a speaker system, but I'm really psyched to get the sound really, really going in here, like an autofill garage, probably with the door closed, you know. Anyway, tell me what you got on those tires, and I'll catch you later.